I'm just gonna do a little bit of light eyeshadow today, guys. That's all I was gonna do. Just a little easy day look, and look, now we're just in so deep. Hey guys, welcome back. Today I wanted to do a makeup look for you guys because I felt like I haven't done my makeup in a really long time, and I was gonna do just kind of an easy, simple, sparkly day look, and this is what we ended up with. So as the video starts off, you will hear me say that we're just gonna kind of do like a day look. This is not day, this is full on night. You better go somewhere. We got glitter on our lids. We are not playing kind of look, and it just kind of worked its way into this. Like I said, I wanted to do just something easy, simply, and sparkly, but I actually really love how this look came out. So if you guys want to see how to get this glitter, cut crease, wing liner, drama lash, glossy lip look, then just keep watching the video, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Today I want to do a kind of sparkly day slay makeup look, because I got this palette yesterday from Urban Decay. It came in like this really cool press kit. It had some new foundations, which we're gonna try out today too, but we'll get to that when we get to that. But they had this really cool Moon Dust palette in there, and these ultra sophisticated shadows contain microfine bits of iridescent sparkle and lush 3D metallics for an effect that is out of this world. And it says that we recommend applying the Moon Dust with your fingers. For an intense payout, apply it wet and blend the edges out with a dry brush. I just read that for the first time. But these shadows just look so sparkly and just gorgeous that I wanted to try it out today. I wanted to do kind of a day look, so we're gonna stay more on the neutral spectrum of this palette, but they are so shiny and just so pigmented and sparkly and glittery, like that's barely like one swipe of my finger. I didn't wanna just jump in right away and be like, oh, I've been away because of this, blah, blah, blah. But I mean, I've been away because I mean, I just moved into a house, we have some construction happening, we have people in and out of our house all the time. I've been traveling a lot, and there's no excuse. I mean, just life gets in the way sometimes, and I, again, just apologize that I'm not a pre-filmer. I wish I was a pre-filmer, it's just my mind doesn't work like that. So, I am here, let's film a video, let's chat through the video, and yeah. Okay, I'm gonna pull my hair up. I do feel a little under the weather, which I mean, comes with traveling and not sleeping and all that stuff. So I was in London last week for about a week, and it was cold and kind of chillier there, and just in Florida, it's just blazing hot. If you go outside, I'm sure you just can bust into a million pieces because that's how hot it is. But London was cool. I've never been like across the pond, if you will. I didn't so much love the food, to be completely honest. It was a lot of like sausage, and I don't eat sausage, and like boiled meats. No offense if you live there, it's just the food was not for your girl, but it was worth it. It's for a photo shoot that you guys will see super soon. Super soon being like the beginning of next year, but I mean, it's already almost the end of July. Is this year flying by or is it just me? So anyways, let's go ahead and prep our face a little bit. I am this work desk. It will blow your mind, okay? It will blow your mind. I'm gonna prep with the Tatcha Pore Perfecting Water Gel Moisturizer. I've really been liking this. I do have oily skin, and it is recommended for oily skin or makeup wearers. I know some girls that have oily skin kind of get a little nervous that they have oily skin and they don't want to apply a moisturizer, but I honestly feel like you're not living life if you don't apply your moisturizer before you put on your foundation. Even if you have oily skin, just try to find a moisturizer that's aimed more towards, you know, oily skin.
How many times can we say oily skin? How many times can we say oily skin? How many times can we say oily skin?
So if you have oily skin, just try to find something that is more targeted towards your skin types, or an oil-free moisturizer. Just, you know, don't use anything that's for like extremely dry skin that's gonna provide crazy intense moisturization, because you probably don't need it because you're oily. But be thankful that you're oily. Oily skin. Then I'm just going to put on a lip mask. Avi, this is my best damn lip mask. If you haven't tried it, try it. It'll change your life. Well, I'm gonna fix my hair because I'm looking like a schmeeb right now. And I don't know if I ever told you guys that I had tape in the extension. So if you're wondering where all this hair came from, I did have my hair taped in just because I knew I was gonna be doing a lot of traveling and I didn't want to be messing with clipping extensions or carrying through with me or missing a clip, you know what I mean? So I just had my hair taped in. It is Bellamy. I think I mentioned it to you guys in the last video. I don't know. Anyways, I'm gonna do a little bit of primer. My makeup is like completely divided. Like half of it's in here in this little makeshift studio I have set up. I'm so over this gray wall, it's ridiculous. But I'm having like a built-in vanity built in to my beauty room. So I'm just kind of, half of my makeup's here and half of my makeup's there. So It's been a bit chaotic, if I do say so. Okay, so I'm not really sure where any of my primers are currently, so I'm gonna use this guy. This is from YSL. We're just gonna go with the Blur primer because I'm not even gonna try to butcher the French part of this, but I really never used this primer. I've had it for a while. It's a more pricey primer, so that's why I'm always like, I don't wanna use you. But we're gonna use him today because that's all that I see laying here. I don't really know a lot about this primer. I don't know if it's a poor, like, smoothing primer or what. I'll be able to tell you right when I put this on my face. It does have a bunch of little gold flecks in it. So maybe it's like a illuminating primer, not sure. But it is kind of smoothing. It is kind of blurring out my pores a little bit. I can see the gold flecks a little bit on my face, but I'm sure that'll be covered up by foundation. Fingers crossed. Okay, so for foundation today, I guess it's gonna be kind of like a little first impression as well. I'm gonna try the Urban Decay All Nighter Liquid Foundation. This is a full coverage, long wear, matte finish, waterproof, and oil-free foundation. They sent me 3 colors. They sent me 5, 6, and 7. I think 6 was kind of okay. I'm more on the fair side these days. Spray tans just come and they go. They come and they go. So yeah, we're gonna go with, I think, 6 today, maybe mix in a little 5, 7, a little too dark for me right now. So it says to shake these guys well before you use them. And then I'm going to apply it, I'm gonna dot it on my face, and then I'm just going to blend it out with a damp beauty blender. It says you can buff these out with a Urban Decay foundation brush, but I'm not really a buffer outer. I'm more of a pounce it out, you know what I mean? So I'm gonna go more with 5 on this now that I just see myself like sitting in front of the light. So I'm just gonna take some on my finger. I mean, I took like a small dot, and then I'm just going to dot this on my face. This is just one pump. Let's see if we can get away with this. Maybe you could get away with only one pump, but I'm like a psycho and I like a lot of foundation. So I'm gonna apply a little more than a pump. But I mean, you definitely could get away with one pump of this foundation. Which is like, wow. Pretty freaking impressive if you ask me. The amount of coverage that is on my face with just a little bit of foundation. Wow. So I'm just gonna do one more pump and see if I can get any more coverage out of this foundation. Even though I'm pretty freaking impressed. I'm going to just apply some with the brush first and then pounce it out because it does seem to dry a little quicker. Wow. It's still the same one pump. I'm just using the brush to be able to spread it a little more than my finger would be able to. I'm honestly blown away right now by this foundation. It's almost like it's blurring pores on my face as well as like covering any kind of discoloration. I don't really usually like a matte foundation either, but this isn't like overly drying matte like past matte foundations I've used before. It's just like enough. Man, right on my fucking white shirt. Okay, so I just got up for a second. I had to go grab my eyebrow brush and I've been gone for probably like 5 minutes. But in that amount of time, I've noticed that one, the foundation has gotten a lot more matte than it was a second ago. I almost look a bit powdery when I'm looking at myself in the mirror, like I've already set my makeup, which I personally don't love so much. Hopefully I can bring it back to life a little bit at the end with a little bit of highlight and some setting spray. And also I've noticed that it has kind of darkened more than I had hoped for. So it is actually a little bit darker than my neck is at the moment. But again, hopefully we can even all that out with concealer and powder and bronzer and all that, kind of help this blend a little bit more. So just a little update, since it is kind of like a first impression, it has darkened and powdered up a lot, but still the coverage is absolutely beautiful on the skin. Okay, let's do these brows. So long, I must have had a superpowers, last 223,000 hours, and it's, watch out for Drake. Stomach on flat, and your ass on what's that? Okay. So we're gonna do more of a day sparkly look. I love sparkly eyeshadows. I don't know why, I just am so obsessed with them. So like I said in the beginning, we're gonna be using the Moondust palette from Urban Decay. And I'm gonna start with just the really light shade, which is called Spectre, which is just kind of like a shimmery peachy tone color. It said that these were best applied with your finger, but I have long nails, so that's not really an option for me. Just kind of going back and intensifying it where I feel like it needs it. These shadows are super pigmented and there's lots of sparkle and glitter on them. It's just, I do think you might be better suited using your finger, but again, since I have longer nails, it's not really an option for me. So then for our kind of crease color, I'm just going to do a buildup of some colors. I'm gonna start by taking the Modern Renaissance palette from Anastasia, and we're gonna go in with the color Raw Sienna. And we're gonna start working this into our crease. So you just wanna keep blending the line until it starts to kind of fade out from being a line, but you still wanna keep it dark enough to where you see that really defined crease there. So the camera wasn't recording when I showed you how to draw that line, but don't worry, we're gonna do it on the other side. A clean brush, this is just another pencil brush to go in and just buff it out some more. We're gonna leave him there for a second so I can show you what I actually did. So all I did was take, this is just an angled brush, it's a really small, thin angled brush, and I went in to Cypress Umber, which is a dark matte brown shade. Hey girl. And then what I'm gonna do is just draw a line to kind of create like just a lot of depth there on my crease, because my crease just kind of folds into my eye. So by doing this, it kind of just creates the illusion of having like a deeper crease. So I'm just going to take a really light hand and draw right above where my fold is. Trying to keep it even as possible with my other eye, but I do have two different shaped eyes. And then I'm gonna start taking Raw Sienna just on that same brush, the original color we used in our crease. And I'm just gonna start going over this line and pulling it up a little bit to start making the line a little smokier, just blending it out. Cause you do wanna kinda get rid of the line, but not really. And then you can switch to a smaller brush. I'm gonna start first with this smaller pencil brush just to start the blendage. And then I'm just gonna take the larger pencil brush just to really get in there and start blending. I should have probably saved the pink shadow for last, but I honestly didn't have any intentions of doing this. I'm gonna keep blending. So we'll probably end up just covering that pink shadow with something else because I basically just rubbed it all off anyway. This foundation's still looking good. I'm just gonna take a bigger fluffy brush here. It's clean, and just kind of get in there and buff some more. I'm just feeling like we should just get crazy now. So I'm gonna go bust out some loose glitter because I can see it from here. And we're just gonna go all out. That's what we're gonna do. These are the LA Splash little glitter ball things. So I'm gonna just use this LA Splash Till Midnight eyeshadow primer. It was with the little glitter ball, so I'm assuming we could just, you know, use this as our primer. So I'm just gonna stick some of this on the back of my hand. Just kind of like a little milky substance. So this color that I'm using is called Angel's Tip. Pretty, it's like holographic gold glitter. I believe this glitter is eye safe, but as always, be careful when you are using glitter. I luckily have never had any incidents, but I have seen the post about glitter in the eye and it does not look fun. So just always remember, be careful if you're losing glitter around your eye area. That is just more glitter. When you try to just do an easy day look and this is what happens. And since we've come so far, it's just like, why not just go the extra step? So I'm gonna do some winged eyeliner. I haven't done winged eyeliner in forever, but hey, let's just go all out. Let's just go all out, full glam, nowhere to go. You know, it'd probably be easier if the glitter wasn't there. And because this is a pretty dramatic look, I'm gonna go with some pretty dramatic lashes. These are the Iconic Lashes from House of Lash. We're wearing these because they're sitting here. Okay, so now that I feel like we've been here for 800 years, getting our lashes and glitter and all that on, we can go ahead and move on to doing the rest of the face. So I'm gonna do a little bit of concealer. My Beauty Blender is there. Where is my concealer? Here it is. I'm gonna use this guy from Kat Von D. This is the new Lock It Concealer. I was trying to tell you a little more about it, but that's all that it says on it right now. So I'm gonna use Neutral 9. And we're just going to conceal as I normally do. I'm using a much lighter concealer just because I still feel like my face is a lot darker than my neck. I mean, I usually use a pretty light colored concealer anyway, but when I notice that my foundation is a little bit darker, I'll opt for an even lighter one because it just kind of ends up evening everything out. And I'm just going to push it into the skin. I'm not even sure what brush I'm using. Go in with our Beauty Blender, just mainly like around the edges of everything to make sure everything is smoothly blended. And then of course, you know, I'm gonna set it with my Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder. Really light pressure. So now I feel like our foundation is just looking a lot better than it was a second ago. Still love the coverage. The coverage looks so good. It hasn't moved. It hasn't budged. It just looks so good. And I feel like it's a really good test to sit in front of these lights to see how your foundation holds up with like extreme heat, because it is extremely hot right here. Okay, so to bronze up the face, I'm gonna use my Kat Von D Shade and Light palette. I have tried to leave it and come back to it and leave it and come back to it and leave it and come back to it. And I honestly think that this is like one of the best bronzing kit situations. Just the formula of the bronzers I really like. Experimenting with different ones, I noticed that my contour line would get kind of patchy and look blotchy, and I didn't understand what was happening, and I just think it was like maybe my foundation wasn't dry underneath, or just certain bronzers just didn't agree with my skin as much as this one does. This one is just so smooth on me and I never get like the blotchy line with it. I'm gonna pick up a little bit of the guy in the middle and then the cooler tone and then contour the face with this. And then always I just take the other side of whatever's left, and then I just smooth it right on top of there so that it just kind of seamlessly blends. Just gonna use this guy because he's hanging out here. This is Peaches from MAC, and then this is just a little Bare Minerals blush. brush. I don't know why, but I really like using this kind of brush now to do my blush. This kind of brush to do my blush. Makeup's looking good. Hey. All right, we're gonna do a little bit of glowage. I'm gonna use this glow kit from Anastasia. It's That Glow. I know there's so many right now, but I'm using That Glow, and I'm gonna do a combo of Dripping in Gold and Bubbly. And then we're gonna do it on our highest point up here. We're not gonna go crazy today because we have, you know, sparkly eyes. I just want a little glow to the skin since we have on a matte foundation. That's good. My track just there for everyone to see. It's not ashamed. And I'm gonna do a little here. Okay, makeup, you better come through today. So we're gonna just add a little bit of shadow to our lower lash line to just kind of balance everything out. I don't really like adding stuff to the bottom, but sometimes you need to. So I'm just gonna take that Cypress Umber and our little angled brush, and I'm just gonna do it barely on the outer corner. Like that, just a little bit. Nothing crazy. Then we're gonna do a little mascara on our top and lower lashes. You know, I can't show you the bottom lashes because I can't see. Okay, so then for the lips, I'm gonna use this guy from Eve by Yves. This is their conditioning lip definer, and this is in the color, no clue. It doesn't have a name on it on what the color is. But it's just kind of like a brown, nudie looking lip liner. So I'm just gonna line my lips with this guy. And And then I'm gonna fill them in with this too. Like this if you want to go for that more matte tony look, but you know me, I like a gloss. I do really like it like this, but on top I'm just gonna put a clear gloss, and this is also from Eve's by Eve, and this is their Luminous Shine Volumizing Lip Luster in the color Crystal. Lastly, I'm just gonna add a little bit of my Tatcha Luminous Dewy Skin Mist, just cause we're matte, we're really matte. Probably don't need that much, but I want it that much. So this is the completed look, my easy daytime simple makeup look. Totally different than what I had started when I sat down to film for you guys, but one thing led to another, and now we have cut crease, winged eyeliner, full lashes, glitter, all of the above. I'm not bad at it. I haven't played with makeup in a while, so I'm kind of excited that this kind of turned out like this. I absolutely love how it turned out. I hope you guys love how it turned out. Leave me a request down below. I'm already starting to prep for Halloween videos because they are right around the corner. I don't know if anybody realizes this. If you're not really into Halloween, you're probably like, it's so far away. But if you're into Halloween, you're already marking the days on your calendar like I am. So I am starting to prep for it. So if you have any requests, leave them down below so I can have plenty of time to look for supplies and headpieces and blood and gore and like all that stuff. I already have a bunch of cool ones planned for you guys, so I'm so excited. But if there's any requests that you guys want to see and there's a lot of thumbs ups on those certain ones, I will definitely try to incorporate those into my looks this year. I cannot wait. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed just hanging out, chit-chatting with me, doing our makeup together. As always, I love you guys, and I don't think I have anything else to tell you guys, so I'm gonna go. Bye.